What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're talking about underlay settings in Revit. So underlay allows you to underlay different floor plans, levels, things like that inside of Revit. Now this might seem all straightforward, however it can get really complicated because you really have to understand how Revit approaches this topic in order to be able to utilize it fully. So that's why we have a whole dedicated tutorial just to this topic. Now before I jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses where I take the extra time to go step by step, slowly explaining all of the complex topics inside of Revit. For example, one of the courses is Graphics in Revit, where I just explain, about graphics in Revit and what are all of the settings and features that you need to set up. Also, I have many different courses. I do offer some ready-to-go Revit templates, which might be interesting. We have some really high-quality Revit families, and also there is a plugin, so you can check it out. Anyways, now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit, and this is what we have. So this is just a house that I've created in another video. You can see it's actually a kind of a split level house. It actually has these kind of split levels, basically, where level two kind of has two different heights. Same thing goes with level one. So if you want to check that video out, I'm going to link it up in the cards above, so you can perhaps see how I modeled this house and just how that works. But anyways, now let's talk about underlay settings. And the first topic within the underlay settings that I would like to cover is the difference between underlay and view range settings. So these can be confused sometimes because they kind of do the same thing, but not really. So let me explain the differences first. So for the underlay settings, let's say I want to go to level two, and then I want to see something that's on level one so I can make an informed design decision. So a couple of ways of approaching that would be with underlay settings, which is here in the properties panel for that view. Under underlay, here we have the settings. And then the second option is to go to the view range and set that up. So let's see the difference. So I'm just first going to go here to underlay, and then I'm just going to set the underlay to level one. So it's just going to go from level one to level two, look down. I'm going to be talking about this later on, but for now let's just hit apply, and now we can see things that are below. And then you can see here, for example, I have these two benches in front of the house, and they are shown in this small underlay kind of half dome presentation. Now I can't really move these, I can't select them, I can't really affect anything on level one from level two if I'm using underlay. I can only see this. So for example, if I'm making a canopy or something, I can see these benches, and then I can say, okay, let's cover those benches so when you're sitting on them you don't get rained on. So that's basically how underlay works. However, if I just set this back to none, and then if I were to change this to view range, and then just uncheck the bottom and the view depth to unlimited and hit apply, now you'll see we do see those. We can't see some of the things inside of the house, but we do see those two benches, and now I can actually select them, I can move them, I can delete them if I want. So I can actually make changes to that which is below. So this So basically what this means is that view range just allows you to, see more of the model. It allows you to just to see further down from that level too. And of course you can edit those things. However, what your view range, or sorry, underlay settings, what they do, and let me just change the view range back to associated level two. Okay, so what your underlay settings do is they basically allow you to underlay that particular floor plan below that. So it's just like taking another view. So for example, if you're working with those kind of transparent paper and you're kind of drawing, it just allows you to take another sketch and place it below, behind, so you can use that kind of to make informed decisions, whereas underlay is just taking your model and just extending extending how far down you see. So that's the difference. Now let's talk about these settings themselves. So here I have a section of this house. We're currently at level 2, and here when you set the base level to none, that grays out everything else, and that means that basically underlay is turned off. If you change it, here you'll see you have all of the options in terms of levels that we have for this house. So we have level 1, level 2, level 3. We have these additional ones for split levels, but they basically do nothing. The main levels are 1, 2, and 3. So that's why we have these here. So if you set this, for example, I'm at level 2, and let's say I want to see what's below on my level 1, I can say, okay, I want level 1, and then it's also going to give you a top range, which is going to be level 2. This basically means that Revit at this point is looking between level 1 and level 2. Now, if I go to this view here, I can just go and turn off temporary height isolate. So here I've just added some graphics. So as you can see here, we have for this particular floor plan, we have set the underlay to go from level 1 to level 2 and then to look down. So basically Revit is taking a look at everything that's here between this level 2 and then this level 1 here. So this is the base level, this is the top level, and it's showing you everything in between as a separate floor plan, for example, just a separate piece of geometry. Just imagine if it kind of cut this out, like a section box, cut it out, and it's just showing you that. And then this look down or look up is basically just showing you, are you looking down at that section box or are you looking up at it? So for example, if I switch this to look up, it's not going to show me any of these items, and the reason for that is because, well, it's looking up, and here we have a couple of these floors, so obviously from those floors you cannot see them. It's just looking from this kind of line here up, and it only sees a couple of floors and nothing else. Let's make some changes. So let's actually go down to look down. So let's see, where is this? Kind of disappears on you from, oh yeah, I wasn't in level 2. Okay, so let's change this back to look down so I can show you some additional cool features. So there's a specific reason why I chose this particular house model, and it is because it has these split levels, because that kind of informs how this underlay is going to work. So in this case, because we're looking down, you can see that here we can see this car here, but for example, we cannot see this table. So we have this kitchen round table and we cannot see it here. However, we can see the car. Well, the reason for that is because the car is not being blocked by this floor here, because it's above that top level. It's above level 2, so it's not blocking the view. This one is blocking the view, so we cannot see those desks and chairs. So that's basically what's going on here. So it's really going to be kind of taking a look at every, or actually I don't think it's the, it's actually the ceiling. Yeah, sorry, not the floor. It's going to ignore the floor, but the ceiling is there. It's not there above the car. So the ceiling is there, so it's kind of blocking that view. As you can see, when we select that ceiling, it becomes blue and therefore transparent. And then you can see that desk and or that table with chairs. So the ceiling here is blocking the view because it's below that top level. Now also here, this ceiling makes things interesting, because then you can use this underlay settings inside of your level 1 for level 1. So let's see what that means. So in this case, we're just using it for level 2 to see what's down below on level 1. However, what if we were on level 1? So let's say we're on level 1 and then we want to set the view range, and I'm just going to set it again to the same thing. So just level 1 to level 2, look down, hit apply, and pretty much nothing will change. We see some of these lines where the walls are below, but that's pretty much nothing, not a major change. However, if we change this to look up, so let's rotate this arrow around, just here for the demonstration purposes, and then let's go back here and change this to look up. Now what you'll see is here it's looking at everything between base level and top level, and in this case the ceiling is there. So it's just showing us the ceiling, and on the ceiling we have these lights. You can see here we have these lighting fixtures. So it's just showing us those lighting fixtures here in our floor plan. So if by any chance you might want to represent your ceiling and your light fixtures inside of your floor plan, you can actually use your underlay settings for that. So I think that's really interesting. Now, also one thing to consider as well is that these underlay settings are going to work different if you have something blocking the view. So for example, if I'm here in level 3 and I've just kind of extended this so I can see the roof as well, if I change this to go down to level 1 and let's change the top level to level 3 and hit apply, it's just going to show me kind of some of the additional things that are not being blocked by either the ceiling or whatever. So in this case, this would go all the way up to level 3. So that would be here. Let's see. And yeah, we're looking down. So let's just rotate this arrow around. So we're just kind of looking at this part of the house, and you can see we can see the stairs there because the stairs are kind of in between there. You can see the stairs, but we don't see the car and we don't see the table here because they're blocked by these two floors and the ceiling. So we can only see the stairs there, and then we can see the stuff that's on the outside, obviously. So that's basically something that you should kind of consider when using these this underlay. It is going to block things if you have floors or ceilings in between. It's not going to show you the stuff that's below. So in this case, for this level 3, I would have to change this to go from level 2 perhaps, and then it's only going to show me the car because, as I said, the ceiling is there blocking the table and the chairs. And then just speaking of the roof, if you're at level 2 and then if you change this to look up and then change the top level to level 3 and this to level 2, it's just going to show you the roof. So for example, if you want to display the roof in your floor plan, you can just use the underlay settings for that, and then it's just going to give you an underlay of that particular roof here in this case. So that's just an additional thing that you can use this for. And then finally, let's just talk about why are these underlay settings displayed the way they are. And you can see it's just these half dome lines. Well, the reason for that is because we have a setting for that. So if I go here to the Manage tab, and if I go to Additional Settings, you'll see that here I have half dome and underlay settings. So here for the underlay, by default, it's just going to be no override, and it's going to apply half dome. You can uncheck the half dome. So now, as you can see, these things that are in underlay are in dark lines. And then you can of course change that, so let's go apply halftone, but then for the pattern I can use like a different pattern, and then as you can see now the things that are in underlay are going to be shown as dashed lines. So for example, for the roof, if you want to show it with dashed lines, yeah, you can do that. So that's just one of the additional options for these underlay settings. So what I recommend you do is I recommend you play around with these lines, just kind of moving these lines in the section or in an elevation, just to kind of get a better understanding of what's going on here with these underlay settings, because it can get a little bit confusing. You set them up and then for some reason you cannot see some of the elements, and then it might be annoying. While there is usually a reason for that, there might be a ceiling or a floor blocking that view, so just something to consider. And just one thing, I'm not sure if I mentioned it before, but I think it's important, so if I said it, I can say it again. If you're looking at this, so let's go here and let's set this actually up at level 1 to level 2, so just like what we have here already, look down. Okay, so at your when you're like this at level at the top level being level 2 in this case, it's going to ignore the floor here. So even though the floor is exactly on that line, just because it's below the top level, or it's starting at the top level and going below, the floors are going to be invisible. Everything else, it's not. It's going to be blocking the view. The floors are going to be invisible. However, if you move them down, then they're going to start blocking the view again. And of course, the ceiling in this case is below, so that's why the ceiling is blocking the view. So just keep in mind that even if you have a floor, it might not be blocking the view because it's exactly on the top level, and Revit will ignore it at that point just because it's going to try to help you out a little bit. So anyways, I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to get this project file, and I suggest you do just because it's going to be so much easier to understand this topic if you can kind of play around with that, well, you can find all of my Revit project files on my Patreon page, which I'm going to be including in the description of this video below, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.